Hey there, welcome to Izzo's Place. So we're gonna level this floor so that we can put some tile down. We'll also eventually do the backsplash. Pretty good sized job. Okay, I don't know how much you could tell from the time lapse, but what we've done is we've leveled the floor. I think the leveling compound itself will be able to finish that out. I'm not worried about that. And then even same thing here, we'll feather in that leveling compound. But you can see the crazy difference. We go from like nothing to, I think the heaviest one was 7/8 of an inch, so almost an inch difference in this floor. So it was very important to level this before we try to tile anything. The other thing we've done is I've sealed any areas where the leveling compound can get through. And we do that so we don't waste any compound. We don't want that flowing anywhere that's not useful to us. And also we don't want to have anything drip down into the basement. This piece of cardboard here, that was a pretty substantial hole. So I filled it up with and it's just regular painter's caulk because it dries fast. So I filled it up with the painter's caulk, but then I stuck a piece of cardboard on top of it. So that way we should be very, very well set there. A couple of small holes were done. Got a hole there. Got a hole there. I don't know if those holes went all the way through, but I didn't want to take a chance. All right, next step is I am going to paint the floor with a primer. The primer is a requirement from the leveling manufacturer, so here we go. That's it for the primer. Now I gotta wait 2 hours while this dries before I can put the leveler down. Good thing I have paperwork I can do. Ooh-wee, 8 bags. That was a surprise. Is it perfectly level? Probably not. Is it good enough for tile? Absolutely, I can make this tile floor look great now. Okay, looks nice and dry. It hasn't quite cured 24 hours, but it's pretty darn close. So we're gonna start putting the cement board down. fiberboard down everywhere where there's going to be tile. But I just cut it to size. So now I'm going to mix up some thin set, clean this up, and start sticking it. Whoops, I forgot to set up the time lapse, but we got the backsplash started. Thank you. Okay, so I forgot my iPad yesterday, so I couldn't do any recording, but we didn't get a lot done yesterday. It was just a partial day. So what I did get done is I got most of the backsplash in for this little spot. Decided with the customer that we were gonna bring it just shy of the plate. So when I put the little trim piece on top, it's gonna be just shy of that plate. So I'm gonna stick those and let that sit for a few hours and grout it. And the other thing I did yesterday is I pre-cut the parts for the stove. So the way this is gonna work out is we're doing a herringbone shape. So you see it like they kind of do that. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep this line centered with the stove and as straight and square as possible. I'm gonna pick up all these tiles and put a chalk line down. Then we'll start sticking them. So we'll stick a good bit of it, and then before we get in front of the fridge, I'll mix up some grout and we'll grout that area and we'll grout this backsplash. All right, enjoy the timeline. So you've seen me use the snap cut in the time lapse a little bit. In case you've never used one, figured I would show you how to do it. So these tiles don't have a particular direction. Sometimes tiles will have like an arrow on it telling you which way you need to go. And honestly, since we're doing a herringbone, it wouldn't matter anyway. Because actually, now that I'm looking at it, that might be an arrow. Maybe that should go on the blooper reel. Anyway, I'm going to cut a little piece to go under where the dishwasher goes. Let me double check the measurement. So we're going to cut it 21 and a half long. So I'm going to put a pencil mark there. Put a pencil mark on the other side. So I'm going to line up one of the pencil marks with the little arrow here in the center. I'm going to line up the other one with this metal bar. This has a cutting wheel on it. All this cutting wheel does is scores the tile, and then I push down on it with this piece in the back. And you just do it once. Decent pressure. And then push it down with that, I don't know what you would call that. We're gonna call it the chief leaf just for fun. Okay, that's your cut. It's nice and smooth. Okay, now, we're gonna cut it the other way. Okay, it goes in like that. We're gonna cut it at 5 3/4. And we want, so this, if you need, you can mark your finished edges. You could put an X on the one you already cut if it helps you keep from getting confused. All right, so
So we're gonna put a mark at 5 3/4. And mark at 5 3/4. Okay, so again, we're gonna line up that mark with the zero. We'll line this up with the bar. Then we need one more piece of 10.5 on the cross cut. So since I have this marked, we'll save it. It might come in handy somewhere. Zero, the other one, and so these aren't always perfect, so that's why you want to mark both sides. Now this one happens to be against the fence and it's lined up perfectly, so this one happens to actually be square. It's not always the case. Anyone that tells you that tiling is perfect is selling you something. Okay, now with this one I need to cut out for a water line. So, you know what? Let's show you doing how to do that. So, if it was going to be visible, I'd do like a really nice cut there. But since it's behind the dishwasher, we are not going to worry about that. So we're going to make a notch 8.5 deep, 2.5 over. And a half deep, 2.5 over. And you know what? We'll cut out instead of just cutting out that whole corner, we'll cut a small notch out. Okay, so that's what we're gonna cut, that little piece. I'll hold it up so you can see. And it's always good to mark with an X whatever you're gonna cut so you don't get confused. As you can see, it's raining. That doesn't really bother the saw. It's a wet saw, but it means I can't really set up the iPad somewhere for you to be able to see this very well. So we'll do our best. Okay, here's our mark. So I'm gonna cut out this part with the saw, then I'm gonna cut this, then I'm gonna flip it over and back cut those same cuts so that way we can pop the piece out. So because this is underneath the dishwasher, I'm being a little loose with the lines. You know, no one's gonna see it. So I'm gonna flip it over. We're gonna finish out these two cuts a little bit more and then back cut this.
all you need to do to cut it.
Okay.
And finally, got our piece. Oh! Right. Okay. That's all right. So, my piece is too long, so what I'd probably do is I'd probably grab the cutoff instead of the piece we needed. But that's okay, that'll be a pretty easy fix. We're just gonna cut it shorter. I will cut it with the snap cut. And you already saw that, so I'm not gonna worry about showing it to you. Do 10 and a half. Actually, you know what? We're gonna do 10. So wasted a little bit of time with that mistake, but not a ton. So we're actually just gonna cut it off there. And then it'll fit around that real nice. Where are you? Okay, there you go. Okay, well, I'm a silly boy, but you got to see me cut out for a pipe, and we also got to see me fix a mistake. All right, back to the time lapse for you.
Okay, I wanted to get this point to this point. I wanted the cutouts back there, cutouts inside there, and the cutouts there to be rough. There might be a little bit of adjustment after we start actually setting things with thin set and with spacers, but it won't be very much. So since it's raining, even though it's a wet saw, I'm gonna go put away the wet saw. Then I'm going to take a pencil or a marker, probably a pencil, carpenter pencil, and I'm actually gonna draw these as I pull them out. These aren't exactly where they're gonna go, but I just need a memory aid for the pattern so I don't mess it up. And then all that stuff's a little bit boring. So, I'll see you after I do all that, and then we can start setting. Ooh, there's a little friend waiting for me as I was picking up the tile. He's a big old ugly guy. What's up, Wolfie? Oops, not focusing very well, sorry. Possible, I like to let him outside. He's a noble beast. Thank you.